Greetings, minions. I am your humble narrator, Sideways Thinker. And I'm just here with some more Let's Play this here, Dark Souls 2, Scholar of the First Sin on that there PC. Right, I have been reminded quite dramatically of the fact that I really need to stop looking at the Dark Souls 2 Steam discussion forums, because every time I look in there, I just see lots of people who are... But yes, I just see lots of people who are convinced that Dark Souls 2 is the best game in the series, and I don't get them. I don't get them at all. Just genuinely do not understand those people. I don't get how you can be convinced this is the best one in the series, but then again, people convince themselves of a lot of very weird things. Also, I'm not wearing that mask. But yeah, apparently people do convince themselves of a lot of weird things, so maybe I shouldn't be, like, too surprised that there's, like, an entire community of lunatics who think that Dark Souls 2 is the apex of the Dark Souls series when fucking Bloodborne and such exist, but then again, apparently there's a lot of people who think I'm mad for the fact that I consider Bloodborne to be the best game in the series. Apparently, oh fuck me, I've got a comment where apparently someone actually thinks it's the worst. And the thing is, I can't really say that their reasoning doesn't make sense, because their reasoning for why they thought Dark Souls, they thought Bloodborne was the worst in the series was entirely, no, it was an entirely fair reason. Whoops. Whoops. That reason being that, they thought that it was a very restrictive game, and compared to this one, it was. So, their point was fair. I disagree, but I see how they came to that conclusion. Right, don't worry, madam. Excellent, good. Now let's do our best to not get covered in the green goop. Did we avoid it? Yes, we managed to avoid getting struck with goop. We remain distinctly ungooped. Wait, there's shit there saying, like, beware of ambush. Ambush ahead, try luring it out, and then hurrah for ladder. Oh, you bastard. You utter swines. I was expecting one of those weird crow ninja things. Pretty sure I just heard another enemy drop down somewhere. I mean, I don't know where the enemy dropped down, but I'm pretty sure I heard something. Or was that just my feet? It could have been my feet. It could have easily been my feet. Okay, that said go to the left, but I'm gonna go to the right because I can see a thing. Okay, good. Simpleton spice. Something I'm not gonna use. Lovely. It's great. It's perfect, it's what I wanted. What's over here? Oh, this guy. A completely unnecessary NPC. Hello, you ugly bastard.
Shush. You idiot. Stay quiet. I'm on the run. Don't give me away.
On the run from what?
You're a fugitive too, eh?
No, not really.
Yeah? Why else would you be here?
Okay, I suppose no one actually listens to me, do they?
It's got death written all over it.
Well, because I live forever. Like, I can't die, that's why I'd be here.
You want to climb down here? I can lend you a ladder. But, how much can you offer me? Why, yep, I'm trying to help you, you know? Have you no gratitude? downright rude, really.
I mean, really, you seem to be just kind of arguing with the voices in your head.
I've got a soft heart, so I let you off this once. All right. It'll be just a moment.
Okay, sure. I'll pay you 2,000 souls for a ladder. I mean, I don't know where you got that ladder or where this is going to take me, because I basically never speak to this guy while he's here. I mean, I remember he is here, but I never talk to him.
Go on ahead. I won't offer this deal twice.
Okay. On a related note, if you are wondering... If you are wondering what use he has, because he does come to Majula. Okay, we can't get past that. But he does come to Majula, eventually. If you're wondering what use he is, well, yeah, do you remember that hole that we kept jumping down? This guy, you can get ladders from this guy.
Oh, what is it? What do you need now?
I want to learn your gesture, thank you.
Have you heard? Well, apparently, there's this monster lady, right? And the poison? Does wonders for her body. You know, health and beauty and that sort of stuff. And I thought only human women were so petty.
Okay. And
that creature, she was human once, you know. Yeah. In fact, she was wed to the prince of that nearby castle. But her husband? He had feelings for another. The princess was desperate, sought eternal beauty, hoping that it would restore the prince's affection. You see what I mean?
I'm not telling you anymore. I don't care. Also, what fucking nearby castle is he referring to? Dranglich? Is he talking about Dranglich Castle? Because he haven't been there yet. He better not be referring to the fucking castle I think he's referring to. You know, that one that's somehow above the fucking... You know, the one that is somehow above the bloody windmill. Also, I don't know if there's actually any reason to ever go up there. As far as I can tell, there's no reason to actually follow that up, so we're not going to try. Ooh, hello, big chap. Now, this may not make much sense, but these enemies right here... these enemies are called Grave Wardens, if I recall correctly, and I've never understood what they're doing here. Whoa! Okay, I was warned that there was something up here. But yeah, I've never, ever fucking understood what the Grave Warden is doing in this area. Because they do show up in another spot later on. Trap ahead. Okay, I'm guessing, given there was a lot of be wary of poison, I'm guessing there's a lot of, yeah, audible poison gas. But, yeah, I've never understood what they're doing here. Because they do actually show up later on in another area, in like kind of an underground catacombs-y kind of grave area where they're protecting graves, which makes sense because they're grave wardens, but fuck me. But them being here has never made much sense to me. That's probably someone trying to... Yeah. Yeah. We can't get over this way. No, we could pop down there, but I'm not sure if there's any reason for us to pop down there. I can't actually remember my way around this level all that well, I'm not gonna lie. Be wary of secret butthole. Yeah, the door doesn't open from this side. So it doesn't seem that there is a secret butthole. Doesn't seem that there is, but... I'm sorry, I think I may legitimately be going mad. Because I keep hearing, like, that can't be me going insane, because I'm fairly certain that'll come out on the record. But I keep hearing shit dropping, and I don't know... Like, I don't get it. Oh, wait, hang on. There is a reason to go up there. Like, you guys don't have to be out here that as well. Slowly. Softly, softly, catchy monkey. Oh, there is a reason to go up here. It's not much of one. Roll. Excellent. Roll. Lovely. Okay. Fine, I guess we have to drop down there because I can't think of anywhere else to go. Hi, friend. Bye, friend. Roll. Oh. Well, that was great. What a vast improvement of fortune. Oh, and a spell. Okay, great. It's fucking useless. Useless area. I mean, I don't know. I suppose if you were a sorcerer, you'd be quite happy about that. But unfortunately, not a fucking sorcerer, am I? And I'm getting so sick of the sound of shit falling. Like, why can I hear something falling? Like, all the time. Okay, no point going down there. Like, it's real fucking strange. The sound of a thing falling over. All the time. And this way leads back to... Yeah, it leads back here. Yep, there's Gemini. I've officially got no idea where I'm going. I mean, frankly, there's Gemini. We all always kind of know that I have no idea where I'm going. Oh, no, wait, I know where I'm going now. As I recall now, that whole area we were just in is technically optional. Ah, I knew there was one of you crow bastards here. Yes, I knew there was one of you here. Just didn't know where. Also, this area down there, you may notice with a bunch of kind of dudes lying down, that would be full of poison if we hadn't burned the windmill, because those guys there are literally guarding where the boss is. So you may be wondering, sideways, why are you going up here then if the boss is down there? Well, I'll tell you. Because there's two secret doors up here. And one of them leads to something I can't remember, and the other one leads to a bonfire. Okay, one of them leads to a chest, and the other one leads to a bonfire. Ooh, petrified something. We can give that to those dumb bloody crows. Lovely. The upper earthen peak bonfire. So, we are now ready to go and challenge the queen of this area. Well, we will be ready. Whoops. Once we've dealt with the enemies in front of us. Ooh, malformed claws. What the hell? Malformed claw. One of the malformed weapons developed in Aldia. Developed in Aldia. Aldia is a person. Appears to be, like, within him? Within him. I don't know. Appears to be a crustacean pincer, but its precise origins are unclear. Use strong attack to inflict damage even upon foes with raised shields. The peculiar figure known as Lord Aldi attempted to uncover the secrets of life itself and viewed the undead as a key to solving this mystery. It's a big horrible claw, isn't it? Not fucking using it, but we've got it. Actually, what does it level with? Ah, levels of strength. Which is weird, if you ask me, for a claw-ish weapon. I don't know, I just expect claws to level with agility. Come on, biggin. Okay, that was just unfortunate on my part, frankly. Oh cool, we got his shirt. Personally, I was hoping for his hat, because there's always a stage when I've played Dark Souls 2. There's always a stage at which I'm wearing the Grave Warden's hat. But are you okay? Because you fucking skidded around like nobody's business for a little while, though. In a way I truly did not understand. Beanpole required a... Don't even... I know you're making a joke there, but I don't get it. Beanpole? Ally required a head, therefore try bonfire. Okay, I really don't think an ally is required for this fight. I don't know, maybe that's for someone who hasn't gotten rid of the poison. Let's go in. And deal with the boss of this area. You may notice there is a bit of poison. Whoa. Ow. But yeah, there is a bit of poison here. But had we not dealt with the had we not set fire to the windmill, the entire arena would be coated in it. Like no part of the ground wouldn't be covered in poison. Oh, also, that's a thing, is that Laddersmith Gilligan actually did tell us something quite useful earlier. In that the Baleful Queen is healed by being submerged in the poison. Oh, shit. Come along, madam, come along. Yep, chuck your head. Very good. Very good. Very good indeed. Excellent. And now, the moment that you've all been waiting for. The moment that Sideways Thinker loses his shit. Now, do recall that we are currently at the top of a windmill that there is nothing above. Because it's very high. It's like a windmill on top of a mountain. This is an elevator. Recall, we are at the top of a windmill. Going up. Going up a bit further than I'd expect to be able to at the top of a windmill. We appear to be underground. Curious. Rather curious. Now we're in another area. Ooh, it seems like a warm area judging by those lights. Okay, so we've gone up from the top of a windmill at the top of a mountain. Where are we now? I do wonder. We're in a castle submerged by lava. Fuck this game. Fuck. Jumping fucking Christ. Oh, dear. Sorry. It just makes me mad. Like, it makes me so fucking angry, this area does. And it's not even like the area itself, although if I do recall correctly, this area does rather annoy me for two reasons. Number one, this bridge is a PvP area, like nobody's business. Number two, some of the encounters are annoying. However, they maybe can be less annoying given that I just killed that enemy. And that kind of enemy is basically one of the only enemies in this area, in two hits. I think this area may not be anywhere near as much of a problem as I remember it being. Oh, however, we have been invaded. Thankfully, this is not a PvP invasion. This is a AI invasion. Actually, I say thankfully, I tend to have more trouble with AI invasions. I don't know. I guess it's just when you have to fight someone who's on your footing as opposed to someone whose like move set has been designed in the same way that all the enemies has. Do you know what I mean? Because the move sets of player characters are a lot, frankly, they're a lot less forgiving than move sets in basically any other video game, but a lot more forgiving than move sets in the move sets of the enemies. However, we fucking dealt with her, so now we can continue on. And we got ourselves a human effigy. Lovely. Lovely jubbly. Oh. Oh, old Iron Keep. How I hate you. I think two of these guys just aggroed on me at the same time. I'm not sure. Thankfully, however, my dual attack can fuck their poise, so that's quite useful. Okay, no, I guess two of them didn't aggro on me at the same time. Guess we're cool. Oh, hey, look, it's an NPC.
What? Who are you?
My name's Ether. I mean, Logie. I mean, Logina.
Me? I'm Makarot. Who else? What? Have a look at my wares.
Yep. Just a guy. Ah. Sells bandit armor. Curious. We also got the Jester's set. Which I think we're gonna buy. The Jester's set, by the way, if I recall correctly, is a favorite of people who play PvP. Cheers. There's a lot of people who will walk around wearing the Jester set. Or more specifically, wearing the Jester's hat. Oh, wow, you can't actually tell our character's gender anymore. Well, we're gonna keep wearing what we were wearing to begin with. Brigand trousers. Gaim warrior gloves. This thing. Oh, I kinda wanna wear the Jester hat. Yeah, you know, we'll wear the Jester hat for a while. It raises item discovery, so that's a good thing. And it's not as if we're going to miss the, Well, it was unfortunate that you were turned around, really, wasn't it? And apparently it was unfortunate that you're not paying attention. Odd. Odd man. Ooh, another Pharos Lockstone. We're drowning in these fucking things. Barely any use for them either. And yep, illusionary wall. I don't know, I kind of like the Jester hat. We're not going to wear it for long. I will inevitably get sick of it quite quickly. But, we'll wear it for a bit. You find yourself wondering what the purpose of that is. It's this. Yeah, there's one poor asshole who's just there. Who actually has decided to not react to the fact that I just shot him in the spine. Seemed like a bad idea, especially when I killed him, but ah well, what are you gonna do? Oh wait, I can hear another one. Fuck, where did you come from? Whatever, doesn't matter, you're dead now, but still, I'd rather that you hadn't did. I would have rather if you hadn't done that. Nope. Sorry, I was sitting there trying to remember how we can actually deal with that, but then I remembered that the way you deal with that is by unlocking a thing later in the level. Or by activating a thing, or deactivating a thing, I should say, later in the level, I believe. Right, well, this might be an odd place to stop, but I am recording several videos in a row today, so that is going to actually have to be all for me for now. I've been Humble Murder Cyrus Thinker, and as always, keep calm and carry on. Good day. Well, I hope you enjoyed this video as much as I enjoyed making it. Well, I say that. I could have been having a terrible day when I made this video. You can't tell, and I certainly can't. Pre-recorded message and all that. All the same, if you're interested in seeing some live streaming stuff from me, if you look in the description, there'll be a link to my Twitch page, as well as a link to my Twitter in case you want to keep up with all the random gibberish I spew throughout the week. And if you're feeling particularly generous, you can always donate to my Patreon campaign, also linked in the description. Well, that's all from me. This video's over. Leave. Now. Now!
Do not seek the Sideways Thinker. Do not seek the Pardoner.